follow up with what Travis was just saying. So what I do when I work with families, I conduct highly individual searches and create plans for the students and then present several options. But on a personal note, I wanted you to know that I have two sons, and our sons are 21 and 18. Both of the boys are adopted. So in addition to assisting with clients with all these issues, we're working them at home. So our oldest son is 21. He's moving to LA in August. So Priscilla and I have never met before. It's interesting. So our son, when he was little, would memorize movie tracks, the audio track, just the audio. And if I said one word incorrect, he would say, "No, Mom, they said this, not that."
Yes, yes.
And now he's studying film in college, moving to LA. So when he gets to LA, he'll have an internship in LA and he'll be taking classes out there. And then our youngest just finished 11th grade and he's going to be a senior, a high school senior in September. So for him, we're looking at programs for after graduation. So I know there's some students here today. If I can have a quick show of hands of who the students are, who the young adult students are. Right here. And some in the back also. Okay. So for my theme today, I don't know if anybody had a chance to read Anderson Cooper, wrote a book recently with his mom, Murray of Vanderbilt. Has anybody had a chance to read the book? If you haven't, it's one. It's a
title is from Wordsworth.
Yes, right, The Rainbow Comes and Goes. So that's, I borrowed that for my talk today, for the young adults and the parents. I sometimes for our children, our students, and for ourselves, we want it to just be like happy and no problems all the time. And of course, you know, we all have bumps up and down. So one of the, for the young adults, I want you to know that you're coming at a time where you're working on a wonderful adventure. There will be ups and downs, and you will be okay. So right now it's an exciting time. There's so many options, programs, and accommodations than ever before. So I wrote the talk up, and so for the young adults, I'll go through a couple of things. And I want to give him credit. So our son, who's 21, helped me with the talk. I went over it last night and he said, "Mom, don't say this, say that." So this is what my, for the young adults, my first point was, do your work first and then have fun. And if you do that, you're my hero. He says, "No, Mom, don't say that." He says, "What you should say is don't let the work pile up." So my next thing is, there will be times when you'll feel stressed or feel anxious or stretched. And what I would say with that, you know, expect that they will happen sometimes, and it's important to reach out. And you can reach out to your contact person, like at your school or program, to friends, parents, but it's important to reach out to someone. The other options are that you can stay in bed and the bullet comes over your head, but it's much better to reach out or just sort of hit reset, take a breath, and even if your day hasn't gone well, you consciously say to yourself, "I'm not going to let that be my day," and sort of start fresh. Also, to build an informal team of advisors or trusted people, to carefully select and build a team of people you can turn to whenever you have a question or need information or advice. No one knows everything. It's okay to ask for help. In fact, it's a really smart move. It's much better to ask. The next point is to make friends. Consider joining a club or getting involved in an activity. That way you'll naturally meet people who are, it's a good way to connect with people with similar interests. The next point is, first impressions count. So little things like shower daily, brush your teeth, think about your clothes, your shoes, your hair, and don't ignore the small stuff, basics like making sure you're getting enough sleep, that you're eating nutritious stuff, if you take medicine to take your meds. Those little things can have a huge impact. And then the final point is to exercise. Do something whatever you love. And maybe you love to run or walk or swim or do yoga or bike. Any kind of exercise will give you a sensory break. And that will relieve your stress and make you feel better. So whether you use meditation, breathing techniques, or something else to calm and de-stress, find what works for you. The strategies, the techniques, and the apps. So the next part of my comments is for parents and professional, especially for the parents. And this is hard. I know, because I have the two boys, that's hard. But let them make mistakes. Let them make mistakes, and I understand everybody wants to see your young adult fail, certainly not you. And the cost of these mistakes, sometimes the cost is significant. However, we can't fix every problem. So again, my young son with Asperger's said, "Mom, this is what you need to say. You need to say, parents need to be supportive, but not overly protective, and then to help their child prepare for day-to-day life and let them experience things. So that's his advice. To the parents, I'd say avoid natural thinking, and this usually happens when I work with clients. It's usually one parent, not both parents. It's usually one parent who thinks after graduation, after the student turns 18, suddenly the student doesn't need support. And you know, it's just not true, right? So, you know, keep working on that with your other half. The next part is occasionally I'll have families come with their young son or daughter to my office, and it turns out they really haven't told the student, they haven't really fully disclosed about the student's disability. So I would advise you, it's really important to talk about the disability or learning difference. There's a wonderful talk Michael used to give called, I don't know if you've been anymore, The Power of Knowing. And it's so powerful, you can't advocate for yourself if you don't really fully understand. It's so important to know, whatever it is, whether it's attention deficit, dyslexia, Asperger's, and language-based learning disability. And especially as you either at work or at the college level, they're going to expect you to be able, if you need an accommodation, you just need to be able to say, you know, I have X. And for example, are some of Asperger's, even in elementary school, go to the teacher and say, I have Asperger's, and then, well, like whatever he needed, so I need this. So that's important. In the older year, I think that's, they really need to know their own profile to navigate and to advocate for themselves. We talked a little bit about travel. So I grew up in New York City. When I left the house, my mother never had a license. When I left the house, she gave me 2 coins. The first coin was for me to take the bus. The second coin was for the payphone. That's how old I am. It's no cell phone. So you got a coin for just in case you lost the first coin. I guess there was the second coin. Depending where you live, I live in the suburbs. I have offices in Ramsey, in New Jersey, in Ramsey, on the South River. So it's very different for my children. There are no sidewalks, there's no transportation. So I made sure that in high school, we taught them to be able to come to the city alone. I wanted them to be able to move around, so we taught them. And of course, we wanted them to be safe. We started with into the city alone, and then onto Long Island, and then flying alone. So now the oldest one has flown back and forth. About 2 years ago, he met a young lady on the internet. That's something else. You can come to me later when we finish, and we'll talk about internet dating. But just quickly, so I was very concerned about meeting this person on the internet, but fully vetted it. But they've been dating for almost 2 years now. They go back and forth every 8 weeks. So turns out tickets to LA only cost like $293. And so they go, so she stays with me, and he stays with her family. But that was big the first time. I remember letting him fly alone and going through all the security checkpoints, and he had to be able to read and, you know, get on the right plane, going to the right place, and on the other end, get off too. So, you know, teach them safety, but do let, I know it's a little nerve-wracking to let them go all these places, but I think that is important. And the next piece I would say is financial. At some point, if you have young adults in high school for the parent, make sure that you get them on a bank account, a debit card, a credit card, ATM, so they can start learning banking, cash management, expenses, savings. Because a lot of schools have financial literacy, but they really need to do it in a practical, hands-on way. And better to start before they get a little bit older. For the parents and the students, you don't need to be a chef or like a gourmet cook, but you do need to learn to cook and do laundry and that kind of stuff. That's very helpful. For the parents, I would say, and just the fact that you came today, we're obviously leveraging available resources. So there's some fabulous books. If you're in the city and you need help with transition, this book, and I'll leave them all up here if you want to come see them. This is called Life After High School. It's written by Susan Yellen. Susan Yellen is an attorney. She's the wife of Dr. Paul Yellen, and they have a website, the Yellen Center, so I'll leave that one there. I recommend the book, and she also helps parents with connecting you with programs. She does work, and she's based on Long Island and in the city. From Michael's book, because that's one of my favorites, Make for Good Purpose, there's lots of copies of that here. And then the last one, this transitions into the workplace. In my opinion, my view, the best person in the social skills arena, all the way up to work, is Michelle Garcia Winner. So Michelle Garcia Winner has a website, she has books, she keynotes speeches, she speaks frequently. This particular book is 1 of 12. This one is Social Thinking at Work, Why Should I Care? And that's an excellent book. For younger kids, she has like sort of comic book things, and so she has for every age. And so in my view, she's the best. So final note to end on a high note here, I would say that the parents, you know, relax and enjoy. Be flexible, enjoy your student. And I guess that's about it. Thank you.